According to a recent estimate, Bitcoin mining produces about 37 megatons of carbon dioxide each year. So that's the same amount of emissions as the entire country of New Zealand. So if you take that on a per transaction basis, it's estimated that Bitcoin takes 500,000 times more energy to verify a payment compared with a Visa transaction. So that's a lot of energy, especially at a moment where we are, I think, a crucial moment for addressing the need to take action on climate. If Bitcoin were just a little fad, then maybe that we could ignore this energy inefficiency. But now Bitcoin is estimated to consume 0.5% of all global electricity. Cryptocurrency is increasingly a real concern also as a driver of global emissions, and this clearly isn't sustainable. So I just have a couple of minutes. Would any members of our panel like to comment on this, and what needs to happen to keep cryptocurrencies from becoming such a significant contributor to climate change?
Thank you for that question, Senator. I would note that different cryptocurrencies have different proof systems that use different amounts of energy. And when we built the first computer, it was the size of an entire room. But over time, technology gets more scalable and sustainable. And we've also seen major cryptocurrencies switch over to less energy-intensive proof systems, such as Ethereum's recent move to proof of stake. And the energy here is being used to achieve particular societal benefits. So for Filecoin, those benefits are creating a decentralized storage network, as one example.
Thank you. I'm out of time, but this strikes me as a significant issue. We'll follow up, Mr. Brito, since I'm out of time. But I think this is a really important issue that we can't just say we'll ride that cost curve down when we don't have time to do that. Thank you.